G'day, smart person. How's it going? My name's Dylan Dance. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Grab a coffee. Hold on. Where's my coffee? Yep. Grab a coffee. Grab a chair. Grab a Vegemite sandwich. Look, grab whatever you want. Let's talk some natural philosophy. So today, we're going to be trying harder with Dr. Stone. We've done one video thus far, and it was pretty cool. Found some science, but we didn't try all that hard, so let's watch some more. I'll see if I can find any more physics-y things in the show, and we can break it down. So let's get straight into this one. And before we get into the video, I just wanted to say, yes, we are watching an anime and looking for physics in an anime, and they probably weren't considering theoretical physics when writing the anime, although this show actually might have been. You might be thinking you're taking this too seriously, blah, 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 but as this show points out, society and the world is completely and utterly dependent on science and technology, and almost nobody knows anything about science or technology, which is kind of a shambles, right? So what I'm doing by making these videos is essentially trying to trick you guys into learning some physics and how some of this technology works and how some of the science works, and to try and show you guys how it's actually pretty awesome stuff. So yeah, that's why we're making this. I'm not taking myself too seriously, if you couldn't tell from the suit, and I hope you guys aren't either. So let's get into the video, and leave me a comment down below if you have any good ideas for things that I can watch. Have been getting a lot of comments about Steins Gate, so you can betcha that one will be coming eventually. And if you haven't already, please apply some time derivative of momentum onto that subscribe button.
Hatsudensho. Ato wa kaminari sae kite kureryaa.
Sora no ikari, kaminari ga kita!
Honto ni kichattan da yo.
Lucky sugin daro. Gyaku da baga, saiyaku no patan da.
G-shock da. G-shock sae ariya hatsudenki ga dekiru. Tetsu no bou ni kaminari o otoshite. ハイパワー磁石を科学の力で磁石すんだよ。ロウを溶かす。ブロム。てめえの10年がかりの探索の戦果だな。超絶雷スポットだ。速攻で飛来心を立てるぞ。なんか、ヨグル作ってるよ。ルールはルールだ。少しでも高くしねえと。But
also a great idea.
All right,
let's pause it there because there was a whole bunch of cool things there we can spend a while talking about, from what magnets are to lightning causing permanent magnets and to generators. So let's talk about magnets, but first let me say something that'll help you understand some of the concepts. So keep in mind that if you have an electric charge, like say an electron, right, and you move it around, you will generate a magnetic field, all right? And if you have a magnet and you move it around, you will create a current, okay? So just keep that in mind. So what is a magnet? Well, when you have a material, it is generally made of atoms, right? And these atoms have electrons, and these electrons have this intrinsic property we call spin, all right? They're not literally spinning, but just imagine that they are, okay? So these electrons are spinning, and because these electrons are spinning, they have electric charge that generates a magnetic field, like I told you. So electrons are like tiny little magnets, all right? Now you have a material full of atoms and full of these electrons. You have a material full of these little magnets. Now, most materials aren't magnetic because these little magnets are generally mostly pointing in opposite directions. And so the magnetic forces cancel out, all right? But when you have a magnetic material, all these forces are aligned. They point in the same direction. So that's what creates a magnetic material. And with that, you have pretty much everything you need to understand how generators generate electricity. So you have something that spins a turbine. And if you recall what I said at the start, you attach magnets to this spinning turbine. And what does a moving magnet generate? An electric current. So obviously you need something to spin this turbine, right? And you know, if you burn some coal, that'll generate some steam and that can spin your turbine, or you can drop some water onto your turbine and get it to spin. Anyway, it all results in the spinning of a turbine that has magnets on it, and that's how, for the most part, we generate all electricity, even with at nuclear power plants. That's exactly how it, in the end, kind of works. So, what about lightning? Can it really create permanent magnets, like this show is demonstrating? The answer is yes. So, recall what I said at the start. Lightning bolts are rapidly moving electric currents. So, like I said, a moving electric charge causes a magnetic field. And yes, lightning bolts are hugely magnetic. And yes, things like soil, rocks, can become magnetic after it's been struck with lightning. So this is called remnant magnetization. And sometimes when we think things have become magnetic from a lightning, we call it lightning-induced remnant magnetization or natural remnant magnetization. And some of the naturally occurring magnetic rocks out there, we think were all struck by lightning. How this exactly works, we're not too sure. That is just a theory about all the rocks. It may simply just be aligning all the spins of the electrons making up all the atoms of a rock. So yeah, this anime really did get it right. You could create a magnet using lightning, which would be pretty hard. And then you could create a generator using this magnet. As I've already explained, you get it to spin using a turbine, and you can use manpower or some sort of steam. And yeah, that's how generators work. So yeah, I didn't immediately chip in there because I was hoping you guys would catch on to what was going on. If you recall earlier when I was explaining, if you move a magnetic magnet, it creates electric current, right? So water will. If you attach a magnet to it in the right way, you can create an electric current. And that's what Senku was just talking about. It's an infinite, you know, source of energy. And hydropower, which is what this technically is exactly that. It's what we call a green source of energy. It's a renewable source of energy because it's being generated from water, essentially. So you have the kinetic energy in the water moving the water wheel, but that kinetic energy is generally coming from potential energy that, you know, is being converted into kinetic energy of the flowing water, moving the water wheel, which, you know, moving magnet generates electricity. So I'm just going over it a lot so you guys get it. And lastly, I wanted to talk about something that blew my mind when I first learnt about it. And it's that magnetism is simply nothing more than electrostatics combined with special relativity. Now, I'll explain this a little bit further, but if you want a detailed and a much better explanation, I will link a couple videos in my description. So simply, the reason why magnetism is nothing more than electrostatics combined with special relativity, that is, magnetism and electricity are actually the same thing, is simply because it depends on what reference frame you are observing electric current or a magnetic field. And that's about as simply as I can explain it. So in one reference frame, you'll see a magnetic field, and in the other reference frame, you'll see an electric field. They're really the same thing, just viewed from a different reference frame. Now, if you want more and to truly understand it, go click on the videos in the description, because it does take a while to give some decent analogies of what's really going on. All right, that'll do it for this video. So please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll catch you guys next time.